Maybe the connection seems much to come a bit rounder and down.
So, Rob, I can't hear you very well.
Get a bit rounder. Yeah. Yeah, good. Nice forward, super. And in some strides, you try to give him the option to stretch down a bit, and if he does, then you actually get him back up, so he doesn't have to go down with his head. But you want to have that tendency that you give, needs to fall. Yeah, like that, super. Good. There we go. Like every half arena, every arena, but a few strikes, a little lower, pick them back up. Doesn't even have to let your reins get longer, you just give your hand a bit, you're going to see that he follows. Yeah, super. You'll hear Eddie about that also a lot. Talks about the downward tendency. That's exactly the really important thing at the moment in the international exercise. You want to see that goes follow. Not say in one frame you're going to be focused, but if you like too tight. You want to see that they like to follow the hand whenever you give them an option. Super.
Good.
Big circle, and on the big circle, spiraling in. I'm middle of the circle, so it's really important that you stay in that same distance and don't let him run out and leave. And take your time, right? That's a circle in.
I'm sorry, like a second.
The whole idea is that it goes gently, so you bring him more and more into lateral flexion with the same reality.
Good.
Good. The important thing is that they maintain the input.
Super.
Okay, let's stretch a second. Just down. Good.
There
we go. Take it back up and make a circle. Then you change direction, come back to the circle in the other direction. Forward. Yep.
Good. Very nice. Really nice.
Circle and then really slowly in two or three circles come to like a 10 to 8 meter. Most important thing is that the face is the same, he gets a little more up, even gets more and more lateral flexion, and he has the same amount of propulsion and the circle is smaller.
Yeah.
And then you can give a moment, just stretch your arm, see if it follows down.
Yeah, good.
Getting a little heavy, just try to figure out how you can always give a tiny bit and then they come down.
Good. Yeah. Nice, very good.
Take off all.
Super, really good.
Spiraling in a bit, spiraling out. I nearly always do it with all my horses in my basic warm-up. Play a bit in that circle, get the flexibility there, feel a little bit of symmetrical or not. And especially when I know I'm longer like Wally, I always like to feel that there's some symmetrical, but there's a difference. I can figure out, hey, and pay attention to what's going on. It's a great check. Taking off and running off. Yeah, super trot, really. Canter on the big circle.
Good.
There you go.
Thank you.
if he's gonna do this,
right, then it's that.
It's useful.
Yeah, okay.
Huh? The whole thing with that is also clear your mind, sit there.
Yeah.
And if he's doing funny things, don't look at it. Go around, make another turn, do it again.
Do it again.
And don't
okay.
give him the option to make him do things. It needs to be simple.
And then
you're busy fixing that, and it's the same thing as others fixing that. That goes at the cost of the quality of your
yes.
of your walking pirouette. So why? You teach them the wrong way.
Yes.
Now, if your beginning conditions are not good enough, and it doesn't matter with exercise, don't do it.
Right.
Yeah, the best you have to. But in training, if you more or less know at all, it's not so good, then don't do it.
Okay.
And there are some exceptions that say that the horse cannot do anything. Goofy really has difficulties in doing them because he has to go forward. And so if I make him a bit bigger and he makes him a bit bigger and I know if I'm bigger that's too big, I'm happy. For
yes.
that horse at that time,
yeah.
I'm happy. But in
yeah.
general, I don't think that. That's double tendency, and not really more than that. Yes, he must go to the hand, that's good. Fine. Good, very good. How long? Maybe that's a hold as soon as he comes to make it round. Make it round and have some tumble. Good. Fine. And the moment you feel that the transition comes through, you think about the same thing that we did before, like give the tendency. Now, you remember the first walk stride is going. Now,
okay.
Otherwise, he's just a little bit like, oh yeah, he will go again. This wheel is stalling. Now, he really comes through.
Okay.
That's another thing. And he will really focus on that because they see it so often in the high-level test that they need to make it out of position and then they stall.
Yes.
And when you do this, then you get a tiny little over and the red and the first stride comes through.
Okay.
and the head is a bit stuck in his jaw there. So sitting there, bring your hand a bit in, bring your hand a bit in. Try to tell him that he needs to let go in that wall.
Yeah, good. That's good.
Then he's quiet. His gait is not for a 70%.
Right.
I need to get from 60 to wherever I can get, 65, 67, 70. I can only get that by taking those little things.
Yeah.
The technical part. My gait are not gait for a 70. Sometimes they are.
Right, but they're not this right now.
So if I do that and I get a 7 from a physician, and I also get a 7 from my collective for my extended form because
yes.
of that, then I have. Yeah, my extended form is times 2.
Right.
So then I suddenly have 3 or 4 or 5. 2% of my total test. I had it.
Right.
Nothing to do for it.
Right.
Other than making the goal.
Making the technique right. Yes.
And that's why I'm determined that I'm doing so much. They pay attention to all those little things.
All the details.
The little parts and all the indication of the mark they did.
Yes. Yes.
And that's why Isabel has not the horses that are the flesh.
That's right.
But she nearly always wins because correctness, everything is there.
Yes. Yes. And that's.
Big circle, small circle, on any horse, because it helps me to do all those things.
Yes,
I
got
that.
Yeah.
Like. Yeah.
Yeah.
Right.
And the idea what you did in the warm up already, like give him some moments to stretch. When you do that more obvious every day, he gets that. Then those exercises in the kids.
Yes, because I'm
crazy because he gets that idea of, oh yeah, I can stretch a bit.
Yeah, yeah.
And not like he falls on his face. Initially they think that. But a lot of them they don't want to come. It's also a different exercise that we can learn in the German to drive. Have you been striking? Yeah, you really want to stay over here and you do this and come back. So you need to stay there. That's self-carriage. And what you do now is more or less like fall over there.
Yes.
That's also not like this part. It's fine, it is this.
Yes.
But they need to do it. So
they get
that relaxation. Think about transition to side, yeah, massage. A lot of horses in the top level, even. They get quite high marks for the massage, they get good marks for the Piaf, they get terrible marks for the transition Piaf massage. They cannot get out. Same thing. If they cannot get landed longer and they do this, there's no way to get out.
Yes.
They need to be able to follow your hand. That's why that condition is in there. It's a very good check for the judge, like, do you know that or not?
Right, right.
And you should watch, especially on YouTube, it's amazing how much you can watch on like, especially the European qualifier shows. There's nearly every week one on, and you can see all the guys. You can see that. The real good ones have the beautiful transitions. The not so good ones, quite often, the rest is similar. Maybe sometimes even flashier gates.
Right.
But those little things are not so
good. Yes.
And you have to see them.
Yes.
And here they go. Here they just look at. But they look up to where we should look at. That's what's important.
Yes.
A nice in out, nice transitions. You get a much higher mark and boom. And here you have the Grand Prix too. Canter, trot, and end. Or you see what you see there.
Yes.
And they make it really good, and he's seen it when I wrote it, and he said, you're riding for an 8, the other's riding for a 4, and you both get a 6. He said, they have no idea what they're looking at.
Right. Yes,
and then you don't care, because it doesn't matter. But you should care, because even when they cannot see it here.
Right,
that's
right. Well, it makes for, I mean, clearly, the transition makes for a good exit from your first thing and entrance into your next thing.
Right.
And if you have to go from one to the other, you might as well have it.
Yeah.
Yeah, I
know, okay, pick him up.
Pick you up, remember?
We're going to get to the point where I can just pick him up and he does do that.
Yeah.
Well, he's getting closer.
The more you can get there too.
Yes.
And because as soon as you pick him up and he gets in, he's following you having there.
Yes, and it's all there's a release.
It's all happening when he comes in. Yes. And especially when he does this, when the neck comes back to fight him, because the more he puts really power, the more he teaches his muscle to do this. That's what you give him, and then you get him down. Yeah, that's good. Yeah, right. Yeah, super. Keep the forward. Always when you do things, if you want to get out of the getting out of the box, go forward. Another diagram, same thing. they come here and they make a little circle around you. I think that's how they go to walk.
Wait, what?
So you come here and make a little circle around you. Come here and circle around you. Kind of a circle like here. Look at that circle you go to walk.
Come on, you can stay here. Exhale too, so it's for you also easier to sit in the right moment. Good again.